Hello, fellow quarantiners. This is Heynia Cooley from my kitchen here in Scotts Valley. And my son and I were just talking and trying to figure out a way to combine our love of both food and wine and maybe put together some sort of series of cooking classes along with wine pairings. So our series is called Mom and Somm. I'm the mom. And then my son, Ryan, is the Somm. So he will be joining us later to pair some beautiful wines, affordable wines, with this lovely recipe of mine that's called the twice as nice double stuffed sweet potato. If your family doesn't like sweet potatoes, you can use this recipe in just a regular old russet potato, or any potato of your choice. Okay, so I'm going to let you know what we are using here for this recipe. So this recipe can be completely vegetarian, but if you want to add a protein source, and that's kind of what my family loves, you can throw in a pound of ground turkey or ground chicken. Make sure it's organic. And one of my favorite brands is Mary's Free Range Organic Meats, and we're gonna use chicken tonight. And it's just a great quality ingredient. You're gonna need two sweet potatoes, and you're gonna need an onion, couple cloves of garlic. Have fun with the garlic. We love garlic, and so I tend to overdo it, so just use as much for your taste. You're gonna need some quality olive oil, and if you happen to have it, some white truffle oil, and I like to combine those and massage the skin of the sweet potato and then season it, okay? But you don't have to. And I like, that's how I cook the rest of the saute the rest of the vegetables that I'll show you later. Obviously some staples, salt and pepper, and then if you happen to have some garlic powder and onion powder on hand, that would be great. And I also put some hot sauce in this recipe, but you don't have to. Our family's spicy, so we like the spice, all right? And we've got six kids, and so this recipe is fantastic because it serves as its own vessel for the food. So if you wanna have a paper plate night, not do any dishes, then it's great, it holds everything. Okay, so in addition to sharing you with the ingredients, I'm going to go ahead and tell you a little bit about the star ingredients and, hold on. Hello? I won't forget to tell people that you are fantastically loaded with fiber, antioxidants. Yes, yes, okay. Oh yeah, you're supportive of gut health, and the brain and immune system. Okay, great. So did you hear that? Do you remember picking up a banana? If you're telling you to talk on the phone, we are geeks here, and I'm a goober. Anyways, loaded with great stuff, and please eat the skin, as I said. All right, beautiful kale here is next. The other star ingredient, organic, Lacinato kale, loaded with vitamin K, vitamin A, C, B6, great for eye health and your immune system. And then last but not least, we've got this beautiful, look at this baby spinach. Fantastic. It's loaded with A, vitamin C, vitamin K, folate, magnesium, B2. So these are the stars, all right? But garlic's also got some great properties. The onion, the olive oil, so all really, really wonderful stuff. So you're gonna start off, like I said, with the two sweet potatoes. You're gonna prep them, and then, or cut them in half first, and then prep them with some oil, and maybe some truffle oil, and a little seasoning. And then you're gonna put them into a preheated oven, 425 degrees. You're gonna put the flesh side down, and if you can line your pan with a, if you happen to have a silicone, sheet, that's great. Otherwise, foil works. If you don't want to use foil, you can just put it straight on the pan. Just trying to help you minimize any extra cleaning. So sweet potatoes are going to go in for about 20 to 25 minutes, but just keep on checking them. Next, you're going to need about a quarter of a cup, if you want, of your hot sauce. I know it's a lot, but you can play around with that. It's delicious. We like it, but you don't even have to put it in there if you don't want to. You're going to need a tablespoon of butter, real good quality butter, salted. You can even use duck fat, You can use ghee, so a couple options there. Then you want one yellow onion, and you're gonna have that chopped. And then you are going to definitely use some spinach and kale, but you can just choose one or the other. I like the combo, so I'm gonna do a cup of chopped spinach, a cup of chopped kale, and then, as I mentioned, a pound of my protein. This is the ground chicken that I'm gonna use. Then you're gonna need about a teaspoon of each garlic powder and onion powder. You can throw in a little paprika if you want. It gives it a little extra zest. And then with the garlic, my recipe, I'm telling people to use 1 to 2 cloves. I put 4 in because we like the garlic because we're stinky. Okay, and I think that's just about it. So let's go ahead and get ourselves prepped. And when you're all prepped and ready, I'll be all prepped and ready. And then we are gonna return and start cooking. This is so fun doing this. I haven't done this in a long time. Okay. And then in we go. Get those greens going. We're gonna mix them all in with the onion and the garlic. I didn't get emotional with the onion today. I'm shocked. Because normally when I cut it, I'm always crying, but I guess because it was in the refrigerator, it wasn't as potent. Okay, I'm just gonna do a quick rinse of my hands. Oh my, here, that sounds so good, right? So look at how pretty. All the greens. And the greens will reduce down quite a bit. So you're just gonna basically, keep this going until the onions are translucent. And just kind of keep a nice little eye on it. You know, I'm gonna turn down the temperature. Want about anywhere from a medium to a low heat. All right. Now, if you are doing the vegetarian version of this, after this is done, you're gonna just add your seasoning, and then I'll show you how to stuff the potato, and that's it. All right, so this is looking pretty good. Maybe about, I'd say another 3 more minutes or so, and then you'll be able to tell, you'll see that translucency in the onion, and then you're gonna start to get this nice, yummy aroma. It smells like it's cooked. You can smell the garlic and the onion, of course, but it's pretty good. All right, so when this is done, I'm gonna transfer it to a bowl, cook the meat, and at that time, our potatoes should be done and we can get going with the rest of it. Okay, see ya. The sweet potatoes are all baked. Look at them, they're so sweet. And then the chicken is all ground and seasoned. And then here is the sauteed garlic, kale, spinach, and onions. So what we're gonna do is the little sweet potatoes are gonna be our vessels. So we're gonna take the veggie part, the onions, kale, spinach, and garlic, and we're gonna put it in with the meat. Get rid of that. And then, let's see if these are, they're pretty good. Oh my gosh. Then you're just gonna scoop the flesh out of the potato, the papa. Oh, they're still a little hot, but I wanna kinda get through this. Okay, so you're basically making a little holder for all of the insides that we're gonna put in here, okay? So got this going on, and it's a little hot, so I'm going to use my towel. And I'm excited because Ryan's here with some wine suggestions. And moving forward with our Mom and Somm classes and demonstrations, my son said, why don't you just show me how to cook? Why don't you have me involved? And I can do the step-by-step, parts of the recipe, and we can talk wine. And so, well, he's a thinker, that kid. All about the food and the wine. Okay, so getting this flesh out, and just make sure you don't go too deep so that you get the skin. So any spoon will do, just kind of scoop it on out. Got a melon scooper, that works good too. just haul it on out. Look at that. So I'm a Italian, Spanish, Mexican, and German. Men and women all cooked. A lot of them didn't measure stuff, so that's why a lot of the recipes, you just had to kind of eyeball it. So that was kind of tough for me when I was working with my clients and sharing the recipes. I had to write down the exact measurements. So here we are, the last potato. So I've got my mixture. It's real, look at that color. So it's really pretty. And I'm just gonna combine it together. And then once it's all combined, I'm gonna restuff into those shells. And then they're gonna just go back in the oven for maybe about 3 to 5 minutes. And if you wanna throw some feta, or goat cheese would be really good with this too. Maybe an herb goat cheese. You don't have to. I'm not gonna put cheese on it because sadly, we ate it all. So all we have is this. Hi again, look who I have with me now. It's my son, Ryan Cooley. And as I mentioned, we're going to be preparing meals together now, and he's gonna be giving us some great advice on the types of wines, or in this case, champagne, which was his suggestion for this meal. And it's delicious. You wanna talk? Well, first of all, let me show you what came out of the oven. So here's our adorable little sweet potatoes. And we've opted not to put the sour cream or the yogurt on it. You know, Ryan was saying it might change the complexity a little bit of the dish, so we decided not to do that. But what I am going to do is take the pumpkin seeds, and these are raw. Feel free to do salted or whatever. And you can also toast these, and they're really yummy on top. You can also put some feta or even a little manchego or Parmesan cheese, or like I said, goat cheese. But we're gonna leave them just simple as it is. It's delicious as it is. And then I'm gonna turn it over to Ryan to explain to us a little bit about the champagne that we're having with this dish.
So this is something we picked up on a little trip down to Paso Robles. It's called the Purple Cowboy. They pull grapes from Arroyo Seco, and it's a sparkling wine from Central California that it's got a little bit of a sweetness to it, but it's still got those nice toasty notes that I look for in a sparkling wine. I think it goes great with this dish. It's got a little bit of that sweetness to go with the sweet potato, but nice acidity to cut the dish as well. Alternatively, you could do, you know, something like a red, a lighter, kind of fun, fruitier body red, something like a Pinot Noir. I think Gamay would go perfect with this dish. Mm-hmm. This dish almost kind of screams alternative Thanksgiving to me. So when I think of Thanksgiving, I think of Beaujolais. And I think of Gamay, and there's a lot of really good Gamay crus that would go great with this, all on a budget, of course.
Right, and what we noticed is that we were trying different types of white wines with this, and the sweet potato almost kind of overpowers it with the sweetness. So it was like, you know, it wasn't bad, but oh my God, the champagne. And by the way, the Purple Cowboy, I think you mentioned, is out of Paso Robles. They're adorable little winery. So a shout out to them for sure. But what about red? Would this red that we have here be a good option?
Yeah, so this is just something we had that we're kind of saving in our cellar. This is William Salium. It's their Pinot Noir from Sonoma County, their recent vintage. They're one of our favorite Pinot Noir producers, very iconic from California. And go great with this dish, but we're gonna save that one a little bit longer.
All right, sounds good. Well, once again, this is a beautiful all-inclusive meal that has your protein, your veggies, your fiber, your carbohydrate, all in one. So maybe you wanna pair it with a little salad, and that's it. Keep it simple, especially during this time. It's full of rich flavor, and oh my gosh, to wash it down with this champagne. So cheers to cheers. You, my beautiful son. Cheers to all of you. Stay safe and healthy cheers. In quarantine. And we will be back with Mom and Son, or Somm and Son, and we'll bring you another fun little dish. Thank you. Bye.